entertainment news this week, Charlie Sheen uses his powers as a warlock. And in sports, the NFL is in contract talks.
Now, folks, Charlie Sheen is using his demonic powers to take over the entertainment industry. Now, folks, this is Dreadman, Julie Dredd.
Hey, so Sexy Momma here on Hollywood Boulevard with Elvis the King and a random warlock. And today we are talking about Charlie Sheen. What are your thoughts on Charlie Sheen?
Well, Charlie Sheen will use his demonic powers that I taught him all through school.
That's a warlock.
To overthrow and take over the entertainment industry with my buddy Elvis here. We will use our demonic powers to take over the entertainment industry.
That's guru. This is the guru warlock right here, everybody. And he's above Charlie Sheen, because Charlie Sheen's just a warlock. You know, being Elvis Presley, reincarnated, I'm the damn devil myself, baby. Rock and roll and rolls, I'm above
Watch
all.
Out.
I'm above all. The warlocks are just little soldiers in my game. Some warlocks aren't winners. Yeah. And Charlie Sheen is definitely one of the warlocks that's not a winner, baby, I'll tell you right now, because he's about ready to lose his ass. And you know, if you need anybody, Chuck Lorre, you need someone to replace that Charlie Sheen, that idiot CSI, Charlie Sheen the idiot. You come out here to Hollywood Boulevard and you meet me, baby. You meet the king. And I'll definitely replace that man. I got the music talent, the comedy, and everything else. And boy, do we need a job out here. Rock and roll, Charlie. What do you think about the Warlocks industry?
I have Newt and human rhymes. They're delicious.
There you go.
Fabulous.
Warlocks, everybody, warlocks. Awesome. Can cast a spell on you. Catch the George Bush spell on you.
Yeah. Hey, what's up, everyone? I am here with Elmo, but he's all dressed in Laker gear right now. Very nice. So today, which is perfect, we're going to be talking about sports. What's going on with this whole NFL lockdown thing?
I think it's a piece of garbage, the NFL to lock down and do that to the players. I mean, they need to get some kind of salary cap and some kind of control on everything. But the whole lockout, that's not going to serve anybody's purpose, because we need to be able to go and continue. If they lock it down, it won't be any more games, and we can't have that.
What about this whole thing with Brigham Young? You said there was something going on there?
Brigham Young University has an honor code where they're not supposed to drink, have alcohol, coffee, and tea, or premarital sex while they're in college. And I think that's totally crazy. And one of the players, he had sex with his girlfriend. So they expelled him. And I think that's absolutely outrageous. And Brigham Young is living in the 90s. How do you expect college students to not drink coffee, tea, or alcohol, or cigarettes, and no sex? That's preposterous.
Sex is very important to you, Elmo.
Yes. Gotta have some sex.
You like to be tickled, huh?
I love it. Yeah. Tickle me. How about you?
All right, any final thoughts on this whole sports thing?
Well, the final thoughts of the sports is we got to stop the lockout, and we got to change Brigham Young University rules. Otherwise, we got to protest, baby, and I'm for protest.
All right, there's going to be a lot of angry fans out there if that happens, though.
Hey, that's too bad, baby. That's what it takes, whatever it takes.
All right, thank you so much. I'm going to let you get back to your hustling.
Thank you.
The Predatory Lender presents Blood Money, March 4th, 2011, starring Rossana Woo.